Hi and hello guys, today in this video I'll show you all as to how you can create your own non-stop or 24-hour music station using your Raspberry Pi. So you can access this music station from any of your mobile device or a smart TV using an app like MX Player. To get started or to launch the streaming service, you need a server which is based on Nginx or whatever you pronounce it. Just excuse my pronunciation. So we'll need a server running based on Nginx, and then we need a software called OBS using which we'll broadcast. Okay, so first step is to run or install the server. So to do that, you can use the Nginx installer script that I have already written or provided. Again, as usual, you can find the link for the script in the description of this video. So in order to install or start the Nginx server, click on this raw button over here, copy this path, open your Pi. So in order to download the script, use wget single quotes, paste the path to the script, close the quotes, press enter. Right now I have downloaded it on the home/pi folder. You can download it wherever you want. Okay, so next we need to run the script. So to do that, we must first make the script executable. To do that, the command is sudo chmod space plus x space dot forward slash nginx or jinx or whatever you call it installer.sh. So this command will make the script executable. Then just remove this chmod part over here and replace it with bash, and now press enter. If you are prompted for a confirmation, choose yes. Okay, so first we need to check the Nginx configuration file whether it has been amended properly. To do that, the command is sudo nano forward slash etc forward slash nginx forward slash nginx dot conf. So just keep scrolling down. Now you should see the RTMP part or the RTMP protocol added over here. Press Ctrl X to exit. Now to restart the Nginx server, the command is sudo systemctl space restart Nginx. To check if the server is actually running, sudo systemctl status Nginx. So as you can see, the server is active and running without any issue. So now you can exit. Next, we'll proceed with the installation of OBS. So I have already done a separate video on installing OBS, and people weren't sure about certain segments of the code. So I thought I'll explain it again. So as you all are aware, or if you are not, FFmpeg comes built in with the Raspbian or the now called Raspberry Pi OS package. Okay, so the reason as to why I am compiling the FFmpeg from scratch again is because the built-in FFmpeg does not have the SRT protocol for secure transmission. So that is the reason I am building the FF or compiling the FFmpeg from scratch. Okay, so in order to install OBS, again click on draw, copy the path, head over to the Pi, type wget quotes, paste the path, close the quotes and enter. The script is downloaded now. So first, as I mentioned earlier, we need to make it executable. Sudo chmod space plus x slash pyobs installer.sh. And now we can execute the script. So if you need some more clarity on the installation of OBS, I will link up the video that I did. I will link up the separate video that I published on installing OBS. You can check that out. The link for that video will be provided in the description of this video. So this process of compiling FFmpeg from scratch and then installing OBS will take quite a while. Almost it will take up to 45 minutes at least on my Raspberry Pi 3. So I would suggest you leave the Pi as it is and get back and check on it a bit later. Okay, so the installation of OBS is now complete and you can verify from the sound and video, and now you should have the OBS Studio option appear over there. Okay, so now you can close the terminal. So the last and final step is to set up OBS for streaming. So before that, we need to create a VLC playlist or a playlist of audio files that we want to broadcast or stream. To do that, open VLC and then go into media, open directory, and then select the directory containing multiple audio files and then click choose. So all the files will be loaded. At this point, click on media again and choose save playlist to file. Give it a name and then choose save. You can close VLC now. Open OBS. So we need to modify some settings first. Since we are broadcasting only the audio, we need to tweak the OBS settings accordingly. Click on settings and then head over to stream first. Here from the service option, choose custom and then enter the IP address of your Raspberry Pi over here. So under server option, use this naming. So under the server option, you need to enter RTMP. So under the server option, type RTMP colon double forward slash IP address of the Raspberry Pi on which you have set up the Nginx or Nginx, whatever you call it. If it is the same Pi, then you can just set it to localhost. Localhost, then forward slash LIVE. Okay, remember to have this forward slash LIVE, otherwise the stream will not work. Then head over to output option, and by default you will have the video bitrate set to 2500 kbps. Change it to 200 kbps, that is the lowest possible value, and then change the audio bitrate to 128. Leave the encoder as such and change the encoder preset to slower. These are all to reduce the CPU utilization. Okay, and then head over to the audio option over here. Leave the sample rate as such and then video. Reduce the video resolution on the canvas resolution to 720 and the output scale resolution also to 720. Set the downscale filter to bilinear and set the FPS value to 10. And this option should be common FPS value. After all this is done, choose apply and then OK. Now we need to add the playlist. So to do that, under the sources option, click on the plus symbol and then VLC video source. So in this option, choose OK and then click on the plus symbol, choose add files and then select the playlist that you just created using VLC. And then choose OK. And as soon as the playlist is loaded, you should have your view meter light up according to the audio levels of your song. Now you can start streaming. Click on start streaming option. So if your server is set up properly, immediately the start streaming will change to stop streaming. Okay, so all this is done. Now you can access your stream on your mobile device. Okay, so that is pretty much it, guys. So I really hope that you find this video useful and enjoy playing around. See you guys later. Take care and bye bye.